Thank you, Julio, for the nice presentation. It's an honor and a pleasure to be here, to be in this very prestigious university. Until everything starts, I will tell you a few words about the university I'm coming from. Professor Julio mentioned I'm coming from Cluj-Napoca, which is the center of Transylvania, which is famous from Dracula. And we are happy we have a help, which is a legend. Of course, Dracula never existed. It was a prince of Romania, but he was cruel. And he was punishing hard the thieves, the liars, the corrupted. So it's a kind of personality which would help a lot these days. But he has no offspring, so good, no results. The university I'm coming from is a comprehensive university. We have 21 faculties. Chemistry and chemical engineering is one of the 21 faculties. We have all the natural sciences, exact sciences, mathematics, physics, chemistry, biology. We have history, philosophy, social sciences, political sciences, business, business administration, and 4 faculties of theology, Orthodox, Catholic, Reformed, and Greek Catholic. So, and a faculty of theater and media. It's a difficult university to be run, and I felt this in the last 4 years, because research is for each field something else, and you don't want to know what is for some fields. Today I will present some of the results we got in our group, not all related with biomedical applications of organic and organometallic derivatives. There are some compounds who didn't prove themselves very useful from this point of view, but they proved themselves interesting for chemical communication. So I think it's worth presenting those compounds. A part of the group I'm running now was working on phenothiazine chemistry for a long while with a group which was conducted by Professor Zilberg, who passed away like 8 years ago, and somebody had to take care of his children, and I was the choice to do this. Phenothiazine chemistry is very important from not only chemical point of view, but from biomedical point of view. It's one of the molecules who was used to cure very nasty diseases, and probably you know this from your general culture. What we wanted to do, and is presented in this slide, was to combine phenothiazine in the proper way to get some analog of Tröger's base. Tröger prepared the first base, which is named after him, meaning this diazocene bridge and organic groups here, during his PhD thesis. He prepared the compounds, he tried to characterize, it was more than 100 years ago, no NMR, no modern method, but he succeeded to suggest, to propose in his thesis a structure, the structure known today as Tröger base. The jury was not very happy with Tröger's imagination, so he failed. He had to work a little bit more to get the degree, But he entered the history of organic chemistry with this kind of basis. You can see here the structure of a Tröger base prepared by my colleagues. What is interesting from a synthetic point of view is the way we succeeded to prepare these phenothiazinyl amines. If you check the literature, you'll find a lot of methods, but the yield provided by the methods found in the literature is always small, and the separation of the products is not very easy. We used Buchwald-Hartwig reaction here and Ullmann-Goldberg reaction here, both under microwave irradiation, and we got very good results, very good yields, and it was very important achievement for the group because we use the same amine not only for Tröger bases but for other purposes. The amine themselves are active, we'll see on the next slides. They can be used as they are. Condensation of these phenothiazinyl amines with formaldehyde in acidic medium provided this very nice Tröger basis. We prepared the Tröger basis aiming some biological activity, some interaction with biological molecules, and we are not at all wrong. If we think about the structure of the phenothiazine, which is a folded molecule, according to the molecular modeling, we could have at least these two possibilities. This one with better chances, theoretically, than this one. This one was found in the solid state. We have the crystalline molecular structure determined for these molecules. Again, if we look at these molecules, we have a lot of chiral centers. So the complexity of the molecule is more than the chemical arrangement of the heterocycles. According the substituent on the nitrogen in the phenothiazine group, we have two kind of packings in the crystal structure. This one for methyl and this one for ethyl, the relative arrangement of the molecules in crystal structure is different. We succeeded to separate the isomers, and we have full characterization. The results were published. It's under in Journal of European Journal of Organic Chemistry. I mentioned our interest in the interaction with biomolecules, and here I present some of our attempts. It was until the end, I will do better. The DNA intercalation, we could notice that the DNA interacts with aminophenothiazine precursor and with the Tröger base. We studied the peroxidation of the lipids induced by cytochrome C, and we got good results for the amine, not as good for the Tröger base. We have a group interested in the study of oxidation, oxidative stress, and on blood substitutes. So we checked the auto-oxidation of hemoglobin in the presence of our newly prepared compounds, and we found activity in this respect too. Keeping the phenothiazine on the screen, I present one class of derivatives of phenothiazine with thiazolyl hydrazine. We prepared a series of compounds and we checked the antitumor activity. No very impressive results. Compound one is not as good as cisplatin, and but here you see it's a little bit better. So we can try to improve the properties adding some substituents. Putting together phenothiazine and porphyrins seemed a very good idea to combine the the interaction with the biological molecules, but to join together the electronic properties of the two units, the porphyrin in the central units and phenothiazine in meso positions. And we prepared the mono D3, the three, it's not here, but we prepared the triphenothiazine substituted porphyrin together with the tetramesoporphyrin, tetramesophenothiazinyl porphyrin also. All the porphyrins were prepared according to the general methods presented and under microwave activation with good yields. Of course, the separation of the compounds was the usual flash chromatography, a lot of solvent, and a lot of time. Electronic properties of the new phenothiazinyl porphyrins were followed by their UV with spectra, and we are interested in our group in the fluorescent properties. There is nothing special in the electronic spectra. We have the band for the phenothiazine. We have the SORET band for porphyrin and four Q bands, not very strong in the UV spectrum. When one irradiates either of the two bands, the SORET band or the phenothiazine band, the emission is one and in the same position, which these are the nice colors of the porphyrin, phenothiazinyl porphyrins. There is no surprise, as according to the calculations of our colleagues who are doing this, the HOMO orbital is located on phenothiazine in this example, and the LUMO on porphyrin, so the emission will start from the porphyrin, so we have only one signal. Some of these porphyrins have very nice stock shifts. I think they were in the table. Yes, very nice stock shift. Not very good yield, but we are happy with the stock shift we have.